Hi guys, this is tabletnews.com and I'm here with the AllView Ultra 2 Speed HD, a pretty unusual tablet. And I say unusual because it has an unusual display. It's an 8-inch display. It's made by a Romanian company called AllView, but in fact this is a Chinese tablet that has been rebranded, and that's about it. Once again, it's called AllView Ultra 2 Speed HD. We have unboxed it here at Tablet News, and now it's time for the full review. Well, this is a pretty cheap device. It costs $230 and it was announced in the month of May. It runs Android 4.0. It actually moves decently, as you can see, and it's available in both black and white. Now let's get to the design. As you can see, there's a bit of an iPad thing going on. We got this home button right here, and especially the back reminds me of the older generation of iPad, especially the upper side. Other than that, it's a pretty slim tablet at 9.9 millimeters compared to other AllView models. It weighs 498 grams. And now let's have a look at the ports and buttons. At the front we have a camera. This one is a 0.3 megapixel camera. At the back we have a 2 megapixel camera. At the bottom we have this home button. Also at the bottom we have a bunch of ports. We have a charging port. We have a mini USB port right here. We have a HDMI port. We have the micro SD card slot, microphone, audio jack, and that's about it. On this side, we'll find the volume buttons, on-off button, and here you have an orientation lock button that you can switch as you like. So that's about it, plus two speakers at the bottom of the device, one here and one here, dual stereo speakers. That's the design. The thing that bothers me is that there are very big edges on this device compared to the screen. So that's the only objection I have. Other than that, I'm pretty happy with the look of the device. Okay, so now let's get to the specs. This device has an LCD 8-inch display. The resolution is 1024 over 768 pixels. The format is 4.3. That's why the movies will be seen a bit strangely. Let's see, we've got Android 4.0 here. Let's see exactly what version of Android we've got, so I can show you. It's Android 4.0.3, as shown right here. The CPU inside this device is a Cortex A8 1.2 GHz CPU with a Mali 400MP 4-core GPU. You also get 8GB of flash storage, in case you're wondering, 1GB of RAM, DDR3, micro SD card slot, Wi-Fi. You can also attach a 3G modem via the mini USB port, and as I said, the 2 megapixel camera at the back and two stereo speakers. The tablet supports MP3 files, WAV files, FLAC files, and 1080p content playback. Battery inside, we have a 4400 milliampere hour battery, good enough for about 5 or maybe 6 hours of use. In standby, the tablet can reach 146 hours. Well, one thing that I spotted was that the tablet doesn't actually show you how well it's charging. I put the tablet in for a charging session, and it showed me that it was 100%. When I opened it, when I started it, it only showed 60%, so it has problems with the charging. Other than that, you also get some bonus apps on this tablet, like the Bitdefender Mobile Security, available right here, as you can see. Premium version, available for 90 days in a trial regime. Also, I must mention that this tablet doesn't have a GPS, so remember that. But if you want to locate yourselves and use Google Maps, well, at least it has Wi-Fi localization, so you can use that, since we don't have GPS. Now it's time for the performance review of the device. That's why I'm going to use some of the apps I have here and some of their results. Okay, let's start with the AnTuTu benchmark. Meanwhile, I have to say that in Quadrant we scored 2,288 points. We're pretty close to the Samsung Galaxy Tab 2 7.0, that's called 2600, and this tablet is actually superior to the Motorola Zoom 2 8.2 inch, that scored 1600. In AnTuTu, we scored 2775, that's twice as little as the Galaxy Tab 2 7.0, that scored 5300, and it's also a little bit lower than the Motorola Zoom 2 8.2 that scored 2800. Moving on to the other benchmark results, we've got Nena Mark 2 that I'm going to try and find. Here it is, the Nena Mark 2. We scored 22.2 frames per second compared to the Galaxy Tab 2 7.0 2640 frames per second, so this is inferior, and this model surpasses the Motorola Zoom 2 8.2 that only scored 19 frames per second, so it actually got a decent result in the frames per second test. And finally we've got the Velamo test. In the Velamo test, let's look this one up as well. Here it is, performed earlier. Let's see our latest numbers. Here we are. In the Velamo test we scored 799, as shown right here. That's compared to the 887 points of the Galaxy Tab 2 7.0 and the 1000 points of the Motorola Zoom 8.2. So since everybody in America seems to be buying the Motorola tablets, this model is pretty much similar to the Motorola Zoom 2 8.2 inch edition when it comes to benchmark. If that's important to you, you should know it. Okay, now let's go to the browser. However, if you ask me, Motorola Zoom is a better choice since it's a bigger brand and it should be more stable. Google bought Motorola, so that ensures some stability. As you can see, we have a pretty unique keyboard here. Not only the design is copied after the iPad, but also the keyboard. It's divided for the two thumbs typing, so you can see me typing tabletnews.com. I'll take my time, so you can see me typing in full with using all the keys, tabletnews.com, and here we go. It's pretty unusual to rely on this 8-inch display for a person used to a 7-inch tablet or a 10-inch tablet. Here we are, Tablet News. We're on Wi-Fi right now and waiting for it to load. Here's the scrolling. Looks good so far. Now let's try a little pinch to zoom. Decent. So the browsing is decent. The keyboard is actually a breath of fresh air. I like it, although as I said, I consider it copied from the iPad and from iOS on the iPad. Of course, now it's time for what you're used to, the usual multimedia test. So that's why I'm going to go to the file manager. I'm going to enter the trailer section and show you a movie. It's called Colombiana and it's pretty interesting.
August 26th. Enter the Colombiana Stunt School contest to win a one-on-one session to learn.
Put your hands on the car! Put your hands on the car! This is funny?
No, sir!
No, sir!
Catalina, Catalina, never forget where you came from.
So the video viewing experience is decent, but the viewing angles are not that good. As you can see, I'm not impressed, and the aspect ratio is kind of bizarre. That format 4.3 is pretty bizarre if you ask me. Okay, now it's time for the audio playback. Now that's something really good. I was impressed by the speakers. I may not have been impressed by the video, but the speakers are strong. The speakers are available right here. And they're pretty potent, but Once the volume is turned up to the maximum, the tablet starts to vibrate. But that happens to big companies as well. The Motorola Zoom 10-inch tablet had the same problem. Now let's get to the part that I like the least about this tablet. It's poor 2-megapixel camera. For that I'm going to use our little friend here. Expect some major lag. As you can see, major, big time lag. Try to take a picture. At least the sound is powerful. And let's see the result. Once again, with a lot of lag, and the picture was moved. That's sad. Those are the options available: white balance, exposure, geotagging, and the dimension of the photo. You can also do some video capture, although I doubt it's HD from a 2-megapixel camera. And surprisingly, you can also do panorama. So maybe you like that. But once again, nobody buys such cheap tablets for their camera. And even Google didn't implement a back camera on their Nexus 7 tablet. So let's get rid of the camera prejudice. Other than that, it's pure Android 4.0 experience. Multitasking over here. And if you've seen previous review of other Romanian tablets and Allview tablets, you know that they have this obsession with putting some virtual buttons here, volume buttons, useless, since you already have that those physical volume buttons. Obviously, you also have the settings here, so nothing you haven't seen before. Apps here, widgets here, all the usual widgets you know, all the usual apps you know. Let's try to see if they offer us any extra apps. We have the Apply Store from Allview for you to download some extra application. Sadly, it doesn't work sometimes. We also have the usual calendar, Gmail, Google Play Store, that's important. Some minor companies do not offer access to Google Play Store. And we also have a Notes app that, strangely enough, requires us to work in portrait mode and with this keyboard, so you can type some apps like remember to pick up milk. Whatever, remember to pick up. So this is the Notes app. Pretty strange, if you ask me. The fact that it requires you to use it in portrait mode. And other than that, you already saw Bitdefender Mobile Security as an extra 90 days. You can scan for viruses. You can also check the apps that you have installed. You can also tweak the web security features. There's also an anti-theft option that allows you to locate from a distance, or wipe from the distance, and lock the device once it's stolen, of course, from the distance. Okay, so that's about everything that's bonus on this tablet aside from the usual application. I guess that you probably know that it's time for the big old verdict on this tablet. So on the plus side, it has Android 4.0. It has a HDMI port right here. It's thinner and lighter than other Allview tablets and other Eastern European tablets. It's actually pretty decent when you're using Android for daily. And the audio is very good, good volume. The price is decent at $230. And on the minus side, the cons. Well, the battery is pretty crappy, about 5 hours. The screen is not the best I've had. It's glossy. It's a bit dark, doesn't have that good viewing angles. And let's see, the camera, it shouldn't be here since it doesn't have any quality. And the screen rotation is weird. Sometimes it rotates, sometimes it doesn't want to rotate, and sometimes it rotates when it's not sure what to do. Also, the charging has the problem I mentioned in the review, the strange 4.3 format affects the movie playback, and it's an iPad copy when you look at the design. So people may have trouble with that, and I consider the virtual buttons to be useless. So overall, we give it a 5 out of 10 for design, and I don't like those edges a bit. We give it a 6 out of 10 for hardware and a 7 for operating system and user interface on this device. So overall, we give this tablet a 6 out of 10 here at tabletnews.com. Hope you like this review, and if you like our reviews, follow our YouTube channel and follow tabletnews.com for more original reviews on other such tablets like this one. Hope you like this review, and remember that this is the Allview AllDraw 2 HD Speed. If you like it, you may purchase it, $230. We give it a 6 out of 10. Bye bye.